children. Today, I am here to perform various activities related to light. It is a chapter of class 7th. So, two students of class 7th, Babita and Rajat, are with us to perform the activities. Before starting the activities, I would like to ask you something. Rajat, do you know what is light?
Yes, ma'am. Whatever we see around us is just because of light.
Babita, have you ever noticed a beam of sunlight entering in a room through a narrow opening?
Yes, ma'am. I have seen it many times.
Okay. Now, can you tell me some sources of light around you?
Ma'am, there are many, like sunlight, tube light, headlights of car, and bulb, etc.
Okay. Now, we will start activity number one. We will take a candle. First of all, we will light the candle. Rajat, what is this?
This is a pipe.
Okay, now see the lighted candle through this pipe. Are you able to see the lighted candle?
Yes, it is visible to me.
Rajat, show me. I will also like to see. Yes, it is visible to me.
Okay, now I will bend this pipe. Rajat, now see the lighted candle through this bent pipe. Are you able to see the lighted candle?
Now it is not visible to me.
Show me. Yes, it is not visible to me. Why it is so?
Because light travels in a straight line. It is one of the characteristics of light.
Can we change the path of light?
Yes, yes. When light falls on a shiny or a polished surface, it changes its path.
To show this, we will perform activity number 2. For this activity, first of all, we need a torch. I have already covered this torch with a black paper and there is a small hole in it. Now we need a black chart paper. We will put the black chart paper on the table. Now take a plane mirror and place it vertically on the black chart paper. Place the torch in front of the plane mirror at an angle so that the beam of light strikes on the plane mirror. Keep in mind that the light is visible on the chart paper also. This activity can be seen more clearly when we switch off the lights. Now, what do you observe?
It's changing its path.
Wow, it's surprising.
Ma'am, can we try this?
Yes, you can try this. Rajat, you hold the mirror. Babita, you hold the torch. This activity shows that lights get reflected from a plane mirror. To do the activity 3, we require a candle, a matchbox, a plane mirror, and a black chart paper. First of all, we will light the candle. Now, we will place it in front of the plane mirror. Now, Rajat and Babita, try to see the image of the candle in the mirror. What do you observe?
Ma'am, it looks like a similar candle is placed behind the mirror.
Is it an another candle?
No, it is not the another candle. It is the image of the candle formed by the plane mirror. Now, Rajat, try to change the position of the candle and observe it.
I will also try, Rajat.
What do you observe?
In every case, the image is upright.
Yes, such image is called erect image.
Ma'am, I have observed one more thing.
What is it?
The image size is same as the object.
Correct. The image formed by a plane mirror is always erect and is of the same size as that of object. Now, we will take this black chart paper as a screen. Place this screen in front of the mirror. Now, both of you try to see the image of the candle on the screen. Are you able to see the image of the candle on the screen?
No, there is no image. Ma'am, why we are not able to get the image of the candle on the screen?
Because it is a virtual image.
Ma'am, what is this virtual image?
An image that can't be obtained on the screen is called a virtual image.
That means the image that can be obtained on the screen is called a real image?
Absolutely correct.
Ma'am, what about the distance of the image from the mirror?
Good question. To understand this, we will do activity number 4. To do the activity number 4, we need a chessboard, a plane mirror, mirror stand, and small objects like sharpener and eraser. If you don't have a chessboard, then you can make the same pattern on a chart paper. First of all, we will take the plane mirror and place it vertically on the chessboard. To hold it, we will use mirror holder. We will place sharpener in front of the plane mirror, two blocks behind it. Now, Rajat and Babita, try to see the image of the sharpener in the mirror. Are you able to find any relationship between the distance of the image behind the mirror and the object in front of it?
Yes, ma'am. The distance of the image behind the mirror is same as the distance of the object in front of it.
Babita, would you like to try?
Yes, ma'am.
Place the sharpener two blocks behind and observe it. What do you observe?
Ma'am, the object distance is same as the image distance.
Good. From this activity, we conclude that the distance of the image from the mirror is same as the distance of the object from the mirror. For this activity, we need a plane mirror. Rajat, look at your image. Babita, you also look at your image. touch your right ear. Now raise your hands up. What do you observe?
It's surprising. In the mirror, the right appears left and the left appears right.
Yes.
Oh, now I understand why the word ambulance is written inverted.
Yes, it is written inverted because when the driver of the vehicle ahead of the ambulance looks in his rear view mirror, he can read it correctly and give way to the ambulance. From this activity, we conclude that in plain mirror, sides are interchanged. For this activity, we need a shining spoon, a concave mirror, and a convex mirror. This is the outer side of the spoon, which is curved outwards. Now, Rajat, look your face into it. Is the image is same as that of plain mirror?
No, ma'am. The image is smaller in size, but it is upright.
Now, Babita, look your face into the inner side of the spoon. What do you observe?
Oh, my image is inverted.
Yes. Any curved shining surface of a spoon acts as a mirror. The most common example of curved mirror is spherical mirror.
Ma'am, what is a spherical mirror?
Spherical mirrors are of two types, concave mirror and convex mirror.
How can we differentiate between a concave and a convex mirror?
By simply touching it. If the reflecting surface is curved inwards, it is a concave mirror. And if the reflecting surface is bulging outward, it is a convex mirror. Now, here are two spherical mirrors. One is concave and another is convex. Rajat, can you tell me which one is concave mirror?
Here it is, ma'am.
Good. This mirror is concave mirror because it is curved inwards. Now, Babita, can you tell me which one is convex mirror?
Here it is, ma'am.
How can you say that it is a convex mirror?
Ma'am, because it is bulging outwards.
Good. The inner side of the spoon behaves like a concave mirror and the outer side behaves like a convex mirror. For this activity, we need a concave mirror, candle, matchbox, mirror stand, and a screen. First of all, we will place the concave mirror in its stand. Then we will light the candle. To do this activity, we have to switch off the lights. Now we will place a screen in front of the mirror and try to get a sharp image on the screen. Rajat and Babita, is it real or virtual?
Real, because an image which can be obtained on the screen is called a real image.
Good. Now Rajat, change the position of the candle and observe its image. What do you observe?
Ma'am, it forms larger as well as smaller images depending on the position of the object.
For this activity, we need a convex mirror, a matchbox, mirror stand, candle, and a screen. First of all, we will fix the convex mirror in its stand. Then we will light the candle. To do this activity, we have to switch off the lights. Now we will place a screen in front of the mirror. Rajat, are you able to see the image of the flame on the screen?
No, ma'am, it's not visible to me.
That means it's a virtual image?
That's right. Convex mirror always forms a virtual and erect image. Before starting this activity, I would like to ask you something. Babita, have you ever seen rainbow in the sky?
Yes, ma'am. It looks so beautiful.
It usually comes after a rain shower.
Yes, rainbow can be seen in the sky after a rain shower. Babita, can you tell me how many colors are there in a rainbow?
There are 7 colors, ma'am.
Good. Now, Rajat, can you tell me what is this?
This is a compact disc, ma'am, or we can say a CD.
Are you able to see the various colors on it?
Yes, ma'am, but I don't understand why it is showing these colors.
When light gets reflected from the surface of CD, we see many colors.
Wow, it looks so beautiful.
Yes. To understand this more, I'm having a very popular disc called Newton's disc. This is a Newton's disc. In Newton's disc, there are 7 colors. When we will rotate it, all the 7 colors will mix together and we will get white color. Are you able to see the white color?
It's magical.
I got it, ma'am. That means the white light is composed of 7 colors.
From this activity, we conclude that white light is composed of 7 colors.